Hi, welcome to Mary's Math Club.
Today we will discuss about congruency. But what is congruency? See, this is a triangle. This is also a triangle. If I ask, is both the triangles are equal? I don't know, may or may not be. If I ask that this is a parallelogram and this is another parallelogram, is these two parallelogram are equal to each other? Answer is same, may or may not. So when we can say that the two triangles are equal to each other, or these two parallelogram or any quadrilateral are equal to each other, when both the figures are equal from every aspect, means the angles will be equal to corresponding angles, the sides will be equal to the corresponding sides, only then we can say that both the figures are congruent. To prove that whether the two figures are equal to each other, then we have to prove congruent or not. And to prove congruent or not, there is four conditions. One of them have to satisfy. Only then we can say, yes, both the triangles are equal, both the triangles are congruent. And in the case of quadrilateral also, like the same way, but the conditions are different way. We have to prove that the corresponding sides are equal to corresponding sides, angles are equal to corresponding angles, like that way. And then we can say, from that, when we can prove that yes, the two quadrilaterals are congruent, then obviously we can say that their perimeter is equal, and as well as their corresponding diagonals are also equal to each other. And in the case of triangle, now I am discussing what are the conditions that through that we can prove that both the triangles are equal to each other, means congruent. You see here, this is one triangle and this is another triangle. I am naming this triangle as ABC. ABC. And another one as XYZ. XYZ. So one is ABC and another one is XYZ. To prove their congruency, I already told that there is four conditions. One of them we have to satisfy. One of them have to satisfy. And then we can say, yes, they are congruent. So first condition is SSS. First condition is SSS. This SSS full form is side, side, side. Means if corresponding three sides are equal to each other, then we can say yes, the two triangles are congruent. Suppose if AB is equal to XY, in triangle ABC and triangle XYZ. In ABZ, AB equal to XY. And in BC equal to YZ. And AC equal to XZ. So in this case, we can say that yes, it is satisfying SSS condition, side condition. So that means this is satisfying SSS condition. That means these two triangles are congruent. And generally we use this sign after equal to a cosine. This is the sign of congruency.
by SSS condition, we have proved that ABC congruent to XYZ.
And so we can write right now ABC, BC congruent with triangle. Obviously, we will write here triangle sign XYZ.
ABC congruent with XYZ.
As we can say that triangle ABC is congruent, this is a sign of congruency, congruent with triangle XYZ,
that means we can also say that the perimeter of triangle ABC equal to perimeter of triangle XYZ, and as well as
the area of triangle ABC is equal to the area of triangle XYZ.
So we can say area of triangle ABC,
equal to area of triangle XYZ
when they are congruent. So if they are congruent, that means obviously their area will be equal to each other, and obviously their perimeter will be also same. But when their area is same, we can't say the reverse one. If their area is same, but we can't say the reverse one. It may or may not be. So if their area is equal to each other, if their area is same, we can't say that they will be congruent. That may or they may or may not be. But if they are congruent, then obviously their area will be equal to each other. Because congruency means that they will be, their corresponding things will be equal from every aspect. And now we will go to the second condition. Second condition is SAS, means side angle side. Means if a triangle here and if a triangle here, suppose this is MNP and this is JKL. So in this case, if NP, though in my picture they are not looks like they are congruent,
but we will prove it as a congruent. Suppose NP,
means this side, is equal to
this side, at this side, whatever, we suppose K up to K, okay, this is K inside. So this sides NP, so in triangle MNP and triangle JKL, if we compare between these two triangles, then we will get that NP is equal to KL. And MP is equal to KJ or JK, whatever you say. And if and only if, so this side is equal to this side and this side is equal to this side.
Now these two triangle, now this triangle and this triangle will be congruent if and only if
their including angle of the two sides, and here the including angle of these two sides are equal to each other. Means here MPN and in this triangle angle JKL, if it is, then we can say that they are congruent because it will satisfy their SAS condition. And we can say that yes, triangle MNP congruent with triangle JKL.
But keep it in mind that these angle MPN should be equal to angle JKL, because in this case the angle is, means in this condition, SAS condition, the angle should be the included angle of the equal sides, of the corresponding equal two sides. So these are the corresponding two equal sides, and only this angle and this angle are the included angle. Suppose this angle is equal to this angle. Instead of this angle, suppose this angle is equal to this angle in this same triangle. Then we can say that they are congruent. Then we can say that the triangle is congruent, because this angle is not at all the included angle of this triangle. Now AAS means angle side. So for this triangle MNR, and suppose here is another triangle. Suppose here is another triangle, the name of WXY equal to this angle. So angle MMR equal to angle YWX. Okay, and as well as suppose this angle MRN equal to angle WXY, and side in R is equal to YX. So AAS. So we can say yes, these two triangles are congruent, means the triangle in MR is congruent with the triangle YWX. And in this case, I want to say another thing, that here I have written AAS, but some where you can see that it has written ASA. That means they are saying that side is included side. So if this is ASA, means the side is not that one, just this one between two corresponding equal angle, this is will be satisfy this one, this congruency. And if it is not included side, it's not included side, then this is AAS, then also it will satisfy the congruency. Because when we are saying two angles are fixed, when we are saying about the two angles are fixed, that means the direction of the straight line movement is fixed, and also if this angle is corresponding with this angle, that means these two sides will be like this, and if it is also equal, that means its another arm is also fixed in which direction it will go. So that means these sides limit is also going to definite. This side's limit is also going to definite. It's ending up at definite position. So this line length is also fixed, as well as when we are saying that the two angles are given. When two angles are given. And that's why in the case of AAS or AASA, both the cases, it is satisfying congruency. And combining these two conditions, means AAS and ASA, we also can write that AA corresponding S, means we write like that way, AA corresponding S. I am writing here, after that I am writing it here again, AA corresponding, this is C, corresponding S. Combining these two conditions, sometimes we write this, A corresponding S. But whether you write it or this, that doesn't matter. It means that it is including, coming these two conditions. So, in the case of AAS or ASA, it is not mandatory that the side will be included or outloaded. If the two angles are equal and the corresponding angles are equal, and if one side to another corresponding side is equal, that means it will, they both the triangles are congruent. The side may be included side, may not be. It doesn't matter. Now, the last case, that is RHS. 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 Right angle, hypotenuse, side. It is talking about right angle. Right angle is a very special angle, and that's why it has a special condition also. If it is right angle, then right angle, hypotenuse and side, if these are correspondingly equal, that means two triangles are also equal. So suppose here a triangle, DEF, and here is another triangle. Here is another triangle, suppose TSR. So here is DEF and here is TSR. And very clearly this is the right angle here, this is the right angle here. So according to this condition, RHS means right angle, hypotenuse, side. So what is the hypotenuse? Hypotenuse is the just the opposite side of the right angle. So here hypotenuse is this. So when we will compare between the two triangle DEF and triangle TSR, we will get angle DEF is equal to angle TSR, because both of them are right angle. Hypotenuse DF in this triangle, as I told that hypotenuse is the opposite side of the right angle. So DF is equal to TR, as the TR is the opposite side of the right angle. And side, any one of the side, either this side and this side, or this side and this side. If it is equal, that means, is any one is equal, that means it is congruent. If suppose DE is equal to TS, is equal to TS, then it will be congruent, both these triangles will be congruent to each other. Or if I say that in triangle DEF and angle TSR, DF is hypotenuse, that is already we told it that it is equal, because hypotenuse will not change in a right angle triangle. In a right angle triangle, it is fixed that it is will be hypotenuse, because the opposite side of the right angle. And instead of this DE, if I say that EF is equal to SR instead of TS, then also it will be congruent. These two triangles will be congruent. So it doesn't matter which side we will take here other than hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is fixed, the right angle is fixed, and any of the other side, if they are equal to each other, either the base is equal to the base or the perpendicular is equal to the perpendicular, anyone can be accepted. Anyone can be accepted. Either the base will be equal to base or the perpendicular will be equal to the perpendicular, and then we will say that these two triangles are congruent. So this is RHS condition. And this is the congruency about triangle. And very shortly, I am saying about the quadrilateral here also. In the case of quadrilateral also, just like that way, we will also have to equate the sides and angle, corresponding sides and angle. And there is also some conditions. And then we can say that, okay, they are congruent to each other. And in the case of circle, the radius should be equal to each other, or the diameter, whatever you say. Because diameter is nothing but the 2 into twice of radius. So the diameter will be equal to each other, or for both the circle, the radius will be equal to each other. But after proving the congruency of triangle, one conclusion, we can come to one conclusion that their medians, corresponding medians, will be also equal to each other. Suppose this is the triangle DEF. Here it is the median, one median. Suppose this is the one median A, and here is also one median. Suppose its name is O. My ink is going empty. Okay, now suppose it is another median. Suppose it is A, and this is B. So here this EA median will be equal to SB median also, as the two triangles are congruent, because its corresponding median is here, SB here, because EA's median, the median AE or EA, what median AE, corresponding median is here BS, so it will be equal to each other. Similarly, if the median comes from D2 on EF, suppose it is X, then it will be also equal to the median, corresponding median TY. Suppose if the DX is a median and TY is the median here, so then DX equal to TY, as the two triangles are congruent. The two triangles are congruent means the triangles corresponding sides, angles, medians are equal to each other, as well as their perimeter and area are also equal to each other. But area equal for both the triangles, that doesn't mean that both the triangle will be congruent. So today up to this, keep watching Mahesh Math Club, subscribe, like and share to your friends.